Located on 225 acres in Garden City, Long Island, Nassau Community College, a member of the State University of New York system, has close to 20,000 students attend the school each year. The college mascot is Leo the Lion, and these are his stories of the school's absolute best and brightest who have graduated over the past 50-plus years. Let's catch up together as the Alumni Association of Nassau Community College proudly presents Lion Tales, a Nassau Community College Foundation production on the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
Welcome to Lion Tales, powered by the Nassau Community College Foundation. My name is Aurora Workman. I am president of the Nassau Community College Alumni Association. I'm here with my friend and co-host, Dr. Linda Nadian, a proud graduate of Nassau Community College. And together, we'll share stories that will inspire, uplift, and often amuse you.
Each week, Aurora and I will introduce you to alumni of Nassau Community College interested in sharing their experience here at Nassau Community College, along with the secrets to their success. If you, our listening audience, has any positive news you would like to share about Nassau Community College alumni, engagements, births, graduations, weddings, and or accolades, email us at alumni@ncc.edu and we will shout you out.
Well, today's guest is Algenia Pat Mouzan, class of 2016. Pat first enrolled in January of 1980. She took three classes that year and did not return until 37 years later, and successfully finished by earning her associate's degree in fashion buying and merchandise. Pat is a proud alumni of Nassau Community College. Welcome to Lion Tales, Algenia Pat Mouzan.
Hi, Aurora. Thanks for having me, and Linda.
How are you?
I appreciate you guys having me here.
So let's talk about how life interrupts.
Life interrupts every day, all day. You just have to keep the focus. My life was first interrupted when I realized that I needed money to survive. I went to school at first, and then I took a few classes and realized I needed money. So then I had a job for a little while. But the education is the key to all. You get your education, you make more money, you don't have to worry in a little while, except for about bills.
So what are some of the opportunities you talked about at Nassau Community College that you benefited from?
I benefited from financial aid, which was very helpful because I came from a poor family. I'm number 10 child of 16 siblings. Seventh girl. Wow. I'm the second, I believe, to graduate from college. I have an older sister who came here to Nassau, and she did it first. 13 years we're apart, and I did have going to college on my brain as I grew up because it was a privilege. And I was very thankful that they helped me with the book voucher. And then later on, I find that work study was very helpful to me. Mm-hmm. I worked with you, Aurora.
Yes, Pat worked with me. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Did you find that when you were younger, growing up, you know, going through elementary school, that you had mentors there that encouraged you to pursue college? Or how did you know about the future being part, you know, education being part of your life without anyone kind of telling you and guiding you?
I had an older sister, Betty, that came to college. She worked very hard. As a matter of fact, I didn't even see her much growing up as a young kid. I don't even see her much now because she still works hard. But I had sisters in between that kind of dropped out of regular school. And me and our sister Jane was determined to not to give in and don't give up. And so we immediately shut off boyfriends and focused on school. Now, I didn't do great in high school, which I thought I was not smart. But I passed with passing grades. And then I learned when I got to Nassau, I'm an A student. I was so proud of myself to finally be able to focus. Because coming from a large family, you have chores, you have things you have to do before
school, there's obligations.
After school, obligations, and I was just determined to get a degree.
And we know, I was reading something where Oprah said that it was really her fourth grade teacher that encouraged her to know that she was smart and that she could pursue. And I thought that that was so interesting, because a little 9-year-old girl being told by a female teacher that, you know, you can do too. And obviously, you know, you've done that and Oprah's done that. And it's so interesting to see that it is part of it when you have those positive people in your life.
Right. And I've also found when people say you can't do something, it makes me go at it harder and
right.
do
it. I do the same thing. If you say no, then it makes
me like key to go. Yeah. I'm going to do this.
I'm about to invent some stuff now.
Okay, exactly.
That's why I thought it's really great for you to be on this show, so you can tell people that, you know, everybody can come back. You know, you're a matured student, and you were able to find the opportunities here. And the biggest thing and the biggest step that we want everyone to know is that not only are the opportunities here, but you have to take the first step.
That's right.
To come and get these opportunities. And to make something for yourself.
Right, and even starting off maybe one course or two courses and not overloading yourself and see how well you do. And so many things that interest you. What are some of the courses that you found most interesting at the beginning?
The first course I found very interesting was Black History, history class. I earlier had went to the Hashra Bound program over the summer months, and where I found and learned, you know, my African heritage, which was very interesting. And then as I came to school, I had a professor that taught me of my royalty heritage, which really spiked me up. And now I'm royalty and smart. Are you kidding me? I'm a win-win.
That's one of the great things about when you sit here and have that epiphany, you know, when you're sitting in class and be like, wow, wait a minute, they're talking about me.
Yes.
You know, they're talking about me. So do you remember who those professors were when you first started?
Yes, my professor, Marquita James. Mm-hmm. I don't know if she'd remember me because
she's
I was
still here.
Really young. Mm-hmm. That was the first three classes that I took, and I made sure to complete those. Mm-hmm. And then I had a professor, Angela Bruno. Yes, she's my fashion teacher. Mm-hmm. Very uplifting, very fashionable sense, and very down to earth.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
That's great. So that's when you were, so you had a quite a mix in terms of the fashion and your other studies that came up. What was one of the ones that you decided when you came back that you were going to take? What courses?
I took a marketing course because I knew it would help me. I actually started sewing when I was 9 years old. So I knew I always wanted to do my own thing, be an entrepreneur. And then I needed to learn how to market this thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then I learned to advertising. I loved the advertising class. I don't remember the teacher, but I did well in that class. But mainly the marketing is what was important, to find out how to market the what I had.
And in terms of sewing, do you use a sewing machine, or did you do hand stitching? What were some things that you
I actually started out sewing when I was about 9 years old.
Mm-hmm.
My mom bought me my first sewing machine. But I teach sewing classes now, and you always have to learn how to start sewing with your hands. Mm-hmm. That way you appreciate your sewing machine.
Well, we're going to hear more about Algenia's sewing skills. You are listening to Lion Tales on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHBC. I'm Aurora Workman, along with Dr. Linda Nadian, and our guest today, Algenia Pat Mouzan, class of 2016, is an entrepreneur, a custom designer that creates unique designs, and she teaches sewing to all audiences. So before we left, we were getting ready to tell us about your different sewing skills, how you like to sew. You know, tell us about, you know, that is your
I have business cards, and they say create your own designs, because I think no idea is a bad idea.
Mm-hmm.
And I like to experience and have what you have inside come out. And even though someone thinks like, oh, I can't do that, oh, that's not going to look right. No, don't say that. As a matter of fact, I don't know why I said no, because no is not in my vocabulary. Okay? I'm one of these people that will bring it out of you. All you got to do is come and say, I have an idea, and I will help you explore it. Like I said, I've been sewing since I was about 9 years old. I sewed for myself and doll babies up until the time I was about 18, then myself for about 2 years, and my mom. And then I branched off into helping her sew with her, doing alterations for her friends and herself. And now I'm at the point where I give sewing lessons, and I enjoy it very much.
And is it easy to learn to work a sewing machine?
Yes, it is. Nowadays, they give you a CD to look at. Yes, but the key of sewing is practice, practice, practice. You can't do it one time and think you're going to get it. You got to keep on that sewing machine. Now, hands, which is kind of slow, but you need that to appreciate your sewing machine. And you see how a lot of guys with the cars, oh, my baby, you take care of that car every day. Mm-hmm. You got to do that with your sewing machine. You got to talk to it. You got to give her a name.
She has a portable sewing machine.
Oh, yeah. I carry it with me wherever I go.
She can whip out and whip up something in a minute.
That's amazing. I was downtown at Parsons School of Design, which has a lab. And in the lab, it's a sewing machine lab. And I'd never really seen it set up that way. But it was so exciting because if you wanted to learn to sew and the machines were there, that it would encourage the students to do that and really learn how to do it. So I thought that was really a great, effort on their part, making a lab.
Yes, that's interesting. I learned when I've been here at the school that they have different machines that do different stitches. Now, my machine will do the same stitches, not just elaborate as the machines here at the school. But I was excited to know there were names for the stitches. Because when you learn at 9 years old, you come up with your own stuff.
Right,
you
yeah.
know? And so I really learned the proper technology coming when I'm working with the sewing machines at the school. Mm-hmm. And the proper way to do things in order, because if you don't press your seams, your garment is not going to come out right. Okay. If you don't put interfacing in it, your garment doesn't come out right. So there are little things and little tricks that you need to know when you sew in order to have your stuff look professional. And that's what I've learned, and I've been very blessed because, when you're self-taughter, you kind of don't want to be stubborn.
Right.
You don't want to learn something. I'm always open to learning new things.
You do work for churches and other organizations. Tell us some of the...
Yes, I've made robes. As a matter of fact, right now, I'm doing a line of do-rags for a young lady named Jada. She owns a salon in Elmont on Hempstead Turnpike. She gave me an order for 2.5 dozens for them. I've done other work, but this is like a big deal for me because it's like I'm marketing now. That's where that marketing class came in at. So I'm very excited, and I could teach anyone anything when it comes to sewing because I just have a passion for it, and I love it.
Dang, do you find that people, I know that when you watch things, shows like Say Yes to the Dress, and everyone's looking for their particular design of their wedding gown or their bridesmaids' dresses, and have people come to you with like something in their mind that maybe you could then create for them?
Yes. As a matter of fact, right now I'm going to do a prom dress for my niece.
Oh,
actually, this is my grandniece, I believe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And did she give you a specific design?
Well, she showed me the dress that she wants. What I'll do now is I'll go in, I'll measure her, we'll go shopping for the fabric. If she wants to change it up, fine. If she wants it the same, fine. But I'm for changing because I like everyone to put their own idea into their own garment. If we see something in a magazine, everything don't look good on everyone because we're all shaped differently.
Yeah.
And then, you're small growing up. Now you're a little bigger growing when that you get older. You just have to change some things up. But we're still fabulous. We're all still fabulous in our own way.
Right. Mm-hmm. And what kind of fabric? How do you choose fabric, like velvet versus something soft?
It would be the decision of the client.
Yeah.
Because the only thing I don't work well with would be polyester. Okay?
Yeah.
But there's also different threads that you use to go with different fabrics, and it makes it easier. That's another thing with sewing. You have to learn what goes with what and what would look great made with this. Like, I wouldn't make a velvet, short set because the fabric is for the winter.
Right.
Yeah, maybe terry cloth would work, But yes.
And where do you buy the fabric? Where do you purchase things?
I used to go to Joann's in Westbury.
Uh-huh.
Yes, but I recently went to a place this weekend over on Jamaica Avenue.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, the price was better, a better selection, and I could make more with the fabric that I get than I would have here at Joann's. Mm-hmm. I would have made, yes.
So you have a lot of fabric choices there.
Yes, and believe it or not, guys, I never went fabric shopping for myself. When I was about 17, we had a place on the side of Freeport that kind of water came out. I think it was a fire in a fabric shop. And when someone said, Pat, there's fabric over there. So I took my little car, I went over there, and I see a mountain of fabric. Oh, I was so excited. Can't you tell? I was so excited. I climbed to the top, and I just started shoveling down fabric. And I had it for about 30 years. On and off. Now, I don't have this fabric anymore. It's all gone. But I'm just saying.
You are listening to Lion Tales. Today's guest is Algenia Pat Mouzan. Class 2016 is an entrepreneur, a custom designer that creates unique designers and designs, and she teaches sewing to all audiences, and she's a proud alumni of Nassau Community College. My name is Linda Nadian, along with Aurora Workman, on the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
Hey, I found a toy dinosaur over on the playground.